Good morning, and welcome to Washington National Cathedral on this Tuesday, July the 26th. I'm Rose Duncan, Canon for Worship, and I'm so pleased that you decided to join us this morning for the service of prayer and reflection. Let us pray. The night is past, and the day lies open before us. We pray with one heart and mind. As we rejoice in the gift of this new day, so may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you, now and forever. Amen. Hear these words from a portion of Psalm 79. Help us, O God, our Savior, for the glory of your name. Deliver us and forgive us our sins for your name's sake. Why should the heathen say, "Where is their God?" Let it be known among the heathen and in our sight that you avenge the shedding of your servants' blood. Let the sorrowful sighing of the prisoners come before you, and by your great might spare those who are condemned to die. For we are your people and the sheep of your pasture. We will give you thanks forever and show forth your praise from age to age. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The reading comes from the Gospel of Matthew, the 13th chapter, beginning at the 36th verse. Then he left the crowds and went into a house, and his disciples approached him, saying, "Explain to us the parable of the weeds of the field." He answered, "The one who sows the good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world, and the good seed are the children of the kingdom. The weeds are the children of the evil one. And the enemy who sowed them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the age, and the reapers are angels. Just as the weeds are collected and burned up with fire, so will it be at the end of the age. The Son of Man will send his angels, and they will collect out of his kingdom all causes of sin and all evildoers. And they will throw them into the furnace of fire, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father." Let anyone with ears listen. Our reading picks up as the disciples asked Jesus to explain the parable of the weeds in the field that he had just shared with the gathered crowd, now that they are alone with Jesus. He said that a farmer planted good seed on his land, but while everyone was sleeping at night, an enemy came and planted weed seeds on the same land. Eventually, when the grain began to grow, the workers on the farm discovered the weeds and wanted to root them up. But the owner wouldn't allow them to do so because he knew that they would destroy the grain while they were trying to pull up the weeds. He commanded them to wait until the harvest, at which time the grain could be safely gathered in, and the weeds would be gathered and destroyed by fire. This is one of those uncomfortable texts where Jesus provides a hard truth. Jesus relays that our lives, and yes, our world, are filled with evil, that evil exists. And he asks that we hold this tension. It is true that life and death, joys and sorrows, those things that we want and those things that we don't want to grow and live, they exist side by side in our everyday lives. In a real sense, the grain, the wheat, and the weeds stand together in our world and each of our lives, whether we want to admit it or not. Jesus is brutally honest that evil is real. Evil is a concept and a reality that many in our culture, and yes, people of faith, tend to shy away from. It takes courage to identify that evil is real, intentional, and dangerous. But that is exactly what Jesus does. In the parable, the weeds are intentionally sown, and these weeds, though they resemble the grain, can be deadly. We face many challenges these days as communities and as a nation. Our hope is that the presence of the weeds does not overcome or make God's kingdom absent. Despite the weeds in and around us, the kingdom of God is still here. That is the hope and knowledge of my enslaved ancestors, who believed that while evil and oppression could last for generations, such injustice would end, that the wheat would thrive and the weeds would not. I am a product of that hope. There are more days than not of late that I get a glimpse into their struggles, and I am reminded each day of the most vulnerable among us who are disenfranchised and live with injustice and suffering as their constant companions. Jesus' message is as true for us today as it was for those of his time. Jesus does not deny the harsh realities we face and that there are seasons when evil seems to grow. I admit to my own impatience, but the other message Jesus provides is one of careful, planned action. You see, I'm all ready to pull out my Picture This app, plant identifier, and start to work on the field and yank out some weeds. But Jesus relays, I know what is taking place, so trust me. Jesus says, and this is the promise, then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father. I don't believe that we are to ignore evil. But our call is to be grain that grows strong enough, strong even in the midst of weeds around us, that we are grain that is a blessing to the hungry in need of physical and spiritual food. And to remember this, that the field is not ours, but it belongs to God. Oh God, you have bound us together in a common life. Help us in the midst of our struggles for justice and truth to confront one another without hatred or bitterness and to work together with mutual forbearance and respect through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us offer our prayers to God. That this day may be holy, good, and joyful, we pray to you, O Lord, that we may offer to you our worship and our work. We pray to you, O Lord. That we may strive for the well-being of all creation. We pray to you, O Lord. That in the pleasures and pains of life, we may know the love of Christ and be thankful. We pray to you, O Lord. That we may be bound together by your Holy Spirit in communion with all your saints, entrusting one another and all our life to Christ. We pray to you, O Lord. Let us commend ourselves and all for whom we pray to the mercy and protection of God through Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. O God, the protector of all who trust in you, without whom nothing is strong, nothing is holy, increase and multiply us in your mercy, that with you as our ruler and guide, we may also pass through things temporal, that we lose not the things eternal. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. May the Spirit of truth lead you into all truth, giving you grace to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord and to proclaim the wonderful works of God. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you this day and remain with you always. Amen.